At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. Hi, I'm John Malice. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this Tuesday morning. Hey, my friends, Fresno Unified School District on the front page of the Fresno Bee, top of the fold once again. It's our main topic of the program today, and it's not good news, if you will. 436 MeTV, option 11. We have a board trustee in our studio today to talk about the troubles at Fresno Unified. Back in just a moment after this from Dr. Thomas Casagrande, our sponsor today.
Tonight I want to discuss the importance of the television medium to the American people.
Glad to have you on the program here on a Tuesday morning here on Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno. A programming note for tomorrow. We are going to have someone in here that is with the Right to Life organization. You might recall a couple of months ago, Governor Brown signed a bill, very controversial bill. It was the Right to Die bill. So for those patients who are terminally ill and they don't want to suffer until the end, they can get a prescription drug from their doctor and they can administer, just like they do in Oregon, the right to die legally here in the state of California. We'll have somebody in the studio tomorrow that really opposes that bill that Governor Brown signed in early October. So that's the main focus tomorrow, a very interesting program. Thursday and Friday kind of up for grabs right now, but we'll talk more about that as the next day or two progress. Anyway, you're watching us live on Comcast Channel 375. If you have Comcast cable, that's the only way to go. But if you don't have it, hey, my friends, then over-the-air broadcast with a digital antenna is the only way to go, 43.6, 13.1 as well. Then the replay of this program, this live show between 10 and 11, comes up at 2 o'clock in the afternoon on 13.6 U2, that's over-the-air broadcast, as well as 4.6 at 8 o'clock tonight on Biz TV. And the Twitter account is the same. You can see it up on the screen for yourself at John Malos MeTV. And so the weather's going to be changing, I guess, later this week. We're going to get some rain, at least a couple of these days this week. We're going to get some downpours, which is a good thing. But for now, for today, the weather is outstanding outside. Not even sure you need a coat in Fresno. It's like T-shirts and shorts weather, right? Austin Reed from the Justice Network updates us on the weather situation here in the Central Valley.
John, thank you. Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday to you. Austin Reed here in the First Alert No Wait Weather Center for Connect With Me weather. Yesterday, a beautiful day. We have seen above normal temperatures. It was a gorgeous weekend, and we're going to see pretty much the same thing today. But changes are coming. Let's focus on the now, though, won't we? Here is your First Alert No Wait weather forecast for this Tuesday, the 8th of December. I'm calling for mostly sunny skies, 63 for a high at the Fresno Yosemite International Airport. Tonight, we'll drop down to the low 40s, 43 for your low. Humidity right around 65%. Now coming up tonight in your No Wait weather forecast, I'm going to be talking about a big storm coming over the next couple of days, and I'll have your weekend outlook. We'll see you then. For now, I'm Austin Reed in the First Alert No Wait Weather Center for Connect With Me Weather. Have a terrific Tuesday. John, I'll send it back to you.
Thank you so much, my friend. Austin Reed can be seen on the Justice Network every Monday through Friday, live at 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock. He'll give you the news updates, the weather updates, whatever updates that you want. He's going to have it. It's all part of the Ventura Broadcasting family. So as mentioned here at the top of the program, Fresno Unified School District at the top of the fold again today here on the Fresno Bee. And what does it say? Well, it says basically that the Fresno Unified trustees must hand over all electronic devices dating back to 2009. That means cell phones, I guess computers, anything that they're, iPads, whatever the case may be. And it has to do with these no-bid contracts that have been going on since 2009. We'll get into that in the one man who has been under fire so far through all of this for the past, what, few years or so, is Michael Hansen, the superintendent of Fresno Unified. I want to put up his picture on the screen for you there. Right there is Michael Hansen, going to try to sort through this complex issue right now. We'll get through this whole thing step by step. First of all, Hansen and the school district is under federal investigation for the no-bid contract that went to Harris Construction in the building of Gaston Middle School in southeast Fresno. Hansen also admitted that he and some of his top staffers used an app called CyberDust. What is CyberDust? Well, my friends, the best way to explain that is CyberDust almost immediately erases any and all text messages within 2 minutes. Boom, gone. Well, the best part of this is it leaves no digital footprint. Here's how it all went down. During a private meeting with board members, one of the district's own spilled the beans about Hansen using CyberDust, and that information was eventually leaked to the media by one board member. Trustee Janet Ryan complained it was fellow board member Brooke Ashton who leaked it. And that's when Hansen finally came clean himself, admitting to the Fresno Bee that, yes, he was using the app called CyberDust. Hansen has been raked over the coals by teachers, board members, and the media, some calling on him to resign. Many believe he is arrogant, and how could he have the nerve to withhold information and keep the taxpayers in the dark? Live in our studio right now is school board member and trustee Brooke Ashton. He's our friend here on Connect With Me. He's a return guest. I'm glad he's here. He is on the record as saying that Hansen, what he has done is illegal and is grounds for dismissal. He'll talk about this article, this latest one in the Fresno Bee, right on the front page of today's paper. So the latest news is that in this federal investigation, Fresno Unified trustees must hand over all of those electronic devices, no matter what they are, iPads, cell phones, computers, the whole nine yards, dating back to 2009 in relation to these no-bid contracts. Hey, your phone calls are encouraged. What do you think about this issue, this topic? We've got a great board trustee right here, an honest guy, willing to answer your questions. 436-ME-TV, option 11, back in a moment. At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. Back here on the program, my friend Brooke Ashton is here. Good to see you, my friend. Good morning, and thanks for being here. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Always great to be here.
Well, listen, I got to ask you, first of all, about this article in the Bee. You are one of the board trustees, Brooke, and I guess you have no problem in handing over your devices. In fact, many of these contracts were actually, what I read in the article, were signed after or before you were elected, I should say.
Well, yeah, everything that happened and everything we're reading about happened before I got here, John. So it's
doesn't really pertain to you.
It does not. And a couple of the other trustees came in a little bit later, Chris De La Cerda and Luis Chavez. You know, they came in 2012, and some of this stuff was already done. But as far as turning it over, they want the information that anything that we've done business with on for Fresno Unified on our electronic devices. You know what? Whatever it is, we're going to give it to them.
Yeah. Have at it, right?
Have at it. You know, it is what it is. I mean, they're going to, mine's less than 10 months or 11 months old, and they can have whatever they want to see. It's okay with me.
Yeah. So you were quoted in the paper. I mean, I have several articles here. I mean, look at some of the research I've done here. I mean, I got papers dating back to October here, articles that are very long, very in-depth, very extensive. You were quoted in one of these articles as saying back in October that what the superintendent has done amounts to nothing short of illegal, and that he should be resign or be dismissed or well shown the door.
Some of that stuff, remember, I'm one of seven trustees, and so and some of it is employee-employer relationship, which we really can't, you know, you, in the state of California, the employee has rights, the employer has rights. But I can tell you that as a general rule, any public servant that has a public telephone that the public is paying for, and if they had a device on there, which was, you know, a cyber dust, an erasing device, you have to ask yourself, why? Well, why would somebody have this on their phone? What would the need be to have this on your phone? And what are you hiding from the public? I mean, I can't think of very, very many reasons. I know Mark Cuban wrote into the Fresno Bee, and he was excited that Mike Hansen had it on his phone, and he owns, you know, cyber dust, but...
Well, he invented Cyberdust.
I think he did.
I think he did. I think he's the one that created the Cyberdust app.
Could have been.
From what I understand.
Yeah, and you know, I'm sure somewhere down the line there's got to be a purpose for it. But for our superintendent of 73,000 plus students in the city of Fresno, there's no purpose to have Cyberdust. And the way it came about was he had asked another communication director to put it on her phone, and she said no, I'm not going to do it.
She declined.
She declined. And then when everything kind of came to fruition, she came out and said, hey, he asked me to put it on my phone. He has it on his phone, or had it on his phone, and we're not going to do it. And he admitted to it. He admitted that he had it. And you know, it's just a long. This 2015 has been the longest year that I can remember in a long time. It's been a long year, especially with Fresno Unified. It just seems like we're one deal after another deal after another deal. And then tomorrow night we do the superintendent's evaluation. You know, so he gets evaluated, and some of the board members are saying, you know, well, look at where we came from and where we're at today. And I said, well, you know, the evaluation is not a 10-year evaluation. The evaluation is a 1-year evaluation. Mm-hmm. So if you go from January 1 to where we're at today, I mean, and with the stuff you're looking at, that's tough to give a...
What does this evaluation amount to? What does it mean? Does it mean he can be fired?
He could be fired. He could be given a bonus. He could be reprimanded. Could be his contract's extended. I can tell you that some of the board members are not so happy with the superintendent, and some of them are in love with the superintendent, no matter what he does.
Who are the ones that are not in favor of the superintendent?
You know, I don't know. I think that I wouldn't want to speak for them, but you know, the best thing would be to have them call and see who comes on your show, because the guys that come on your show are the guys that are gonna. I want openness and transparency, and ask me whatever you want to ask me, and I'll give you the answer that I can possibly give you. The ones that don't show up on your show.
Very interesting that you should say that, because I've reached out to just about every board member. I have their cell phones, at least I had them at one time, and the only one that really showed any kind of interest in coming on this program is you. You're here. You've been here like two or three times. Luis Chavez actually came on before he was actually elected to the board, hasn't come on since, so I don't know what that tells me. Maybe they're afraid of the line of questioning. You're not afraid of anything.
Well, I don't know that I'm not afraid of anything. I just think that...
Well, you're open.
If I have an answer, I'm going to give it to you. If I don't have an answer, I'm going to tell you I don't have the answer, and hopefully I can find it for you. And I wasn't there for the muddy details, and so I can tell you, here's what it looks like. I can tell you that that we're in a very serious... situation here. When the U.S. attorney comes in, and when the federal grand jury shows up with the FBI, they're not calling to give you a greeting card or ask you for some suggestions. They're telling you, we want to see these documents, and if it's an illegal act, somebody's going to go to jail. I mean, it's not like the county grand jury where they say, we're going to write a recommendation and we're going to see what we can do.
What did What are the feds looking for? Illegal activity in terms of what? The no-bid contract? See, I'm not sure I'm clear on that or even understand it, even after all the material I've read about it. So you have to, if you're building a school, for example, like Gaston Middle School, we have a picture of Gaston Middle School. Let's put that up. Gaston Middle School built by Harris Construction. So let's say, I'm using this as a hypothetical, let's say that no other contractors came into the bidding process. Is that illegal?
Well, it depends on how you're going to define the bidding process. So first of all, let me say that Harris Construction did a fantastic job on Gaston. And I have no bones to pick with Harris. Or the Spencer family. The my job as a trustee is to be the fiduciary for Fresno Unified and for my constituents and represent the taxpayers to make sure we're getting the biggest bang for your buck. The law says that we need to follow and go along with the lowest, most responsible bidder. And the way that we got the cart before the horse in this deal doesn't look right. When you pass the bond and one contractor gets 51% of the money and 36% of the jobs, it's from day one, Harris Construction came out with $76, $77 million worth of bond work right after the bond was passed.
No other bidders involved?
No other bidders. And so the next highest guy is like Nelson Construction that comes out with $14 million. So you got a $14 million contractor who's a very qualified guy. They're all very qualified. He's your number two guy at $14 million. Your number one guy is at $76 million. There's quite a disparity there.
So Harris built that school for $77 million?
No, the Gaston was $41 million. It was 36 for the building, okay, and 41 for the earthwork, and then you had about 10 or 15 million more that was for moving of the families and buying the dirt. But there was three other jobs that went with it. There was the Roosevelt gym locker renovation. There was Bullard High School renovation. There's Gaston. There was three or four other jobs that they walked out with that I brought
into
question.
You're saying the other construction company had a lower bid?
No.
And they didn't get the job?
No, what I'm saying to you is that there was no other bid.
As far as Gaston is concerned.
That's correct. Okay. And when we passed the bond measure, Fresno Unified just started handing out jobs to contractors.
Without bidding.
Without bidding. And it looks like it possibly could be that the ones that helped pass the bond got the jobs. And I don't think the tax and I don't think the taxpayers
political.
I think, yeah, and I don't, and I'm not sure, but the great thing about it is we've got a wonderful a judicial system in this country, and people are going to look at it, and they're going to make the decision, and everybody's innocent until proven guilty, and, the FBI's looking at it, the grand jury's looking at it, the U.S. attorney's looking at it, and we're going to see what they're going to do.
Could it be that someone did something illegal and someone could go to jail? Some top official at Fresno Unified? Could it be Michael Hansen?
I hope not. I hope my best day, John, is that they come back and they say, you know what, it sure smelled, but there was nothing illegal here, and let's move on and let's get back into the business of educating kids. I don't want to see anybody hurt in this deal. I just want to get justice served. Let's figure out what the deal is and let's move forward. The reality is that we have got to start moving children and teenagers into the next generation of workforce in this country, and we're not there until we can move kids into getting a real job, a career technical high school that we've talked about before on this program. Until we get there, we're not doing our job, and we've got to do a better job.
I need to take a break here in a minute or so here, but I just want to ask you, okay, where does the Cyberdust app come in? Because this has to do with the conversations that went on during this lease back situation or these no bid contracts. So they're trying. So the accusation is, no proof, the accusation is these top officials, including Michael Hansen, they're trying to cover up conversations that took place on their phones. And so they're using this app to erase those conversations. Is that it?
Well, obviously, the app is designed to cover up conversations. Which conversations or which pictures or which things that they talked about, nobody knows.
And that's what's in question.
And they won't say.
Yeah.
Were they being discriminatory? Were they hiding this? Were they? I mean, who knows? I mean, I can't think of a reason that a public official would put this on their phone.
Yeah, it's amazing. Brooke Ashton is here. He is a school board trustee and one of the better ones on that board, I've got to tell you. And 436 MeTV option 11. So it's on the front page of the Fresno Bee again today. It seems like the last couple of months, that's all we've seen. Well, not all, but we've seen a lot in the news. And this has been one of the top stories in Fresno the past couple of months or so. You're welcome to call in and join the program at 436 MeTV option 11. Back after this from Dr. Thomas Casagrande, our sponsor today.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on ENERGY STAR qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. Back here on the program. Again, thanks to Dr. Thomas Casagrande for the sponsorship, talking about Fresno Unified and Michael Hansen, under investigation by the feds, the FBI, and the U.S. Attorney's Office for these no-bid contracts. What? Explain in detail, Brooke, a couple of things. One, what is the lease back option that the district uses? What does that mean?
So here's what it means. Everybody knows what the lowest bid is. You call out three contractors, you have them bid the same project, and you pick the lowest, most responsible guy that you're most comfortable with, right? And in the public works arena, when we're dealing with taxpayers, you have to choose the lowest bid because they're already qualified. They've already gotten bonding. They've already done work there. They've already done all of these things. So lease back means this. It means that...
Hang on one moment, caller. Go ahead.
Lease back means this, that the district does not have to take another bid. They can enter into a contract with a contractor / developer that's going to fund the money because the district doesn't have money to build the project. Say you went to Sanger and they wanted to build a new city hall and they didn't have money. They could go to a Nelson or another developer and say, build us the city hall and finance it for 20 years and then allow us to pay interest. And at the end of the 20 years, we're going to own this thing for a dollar. So we'll pay you everything it's worth and we'll lease it. We'll lease you the ground. You lease us the building. And at the end of the lease, we own the lease because we can't pass a bond. But in Fresno Unified's case, we passed a $280 million bond. We had $100 million in the bank. So why are we using this process? The only reason we're using this process is because we want to pick winners and we want to pick losers. And in my mind, you know, being a contractor, being a developer, it's not a good way to go. It was not a fair process.
Right. So you're saying, you know, we have a bond. Why use the lease back program in the first place, right?
Exactly.
It makes no sense when you've got the money.
And the other thing is, if you're going to use a lease back, then bring in three developers. The only difference between a lease back is going to be, what is the percentage of profit? Contractor A is 3%, contractor B is 4%, contractor C is 5%. Well, you've already qualified all three, so that's easy. You have one opening of what is your profit percentage. You open the bid, you give it to contractor A, he's the lowest guy, move on. But they didn't do that. They just said, hey, John, we like you, come on in. Here, take this money.
Amazing. Caller, you're on the air with Brooke Ashton. Go ahead.
Brooke, let me ask a question. I'm from the Sangha District anyway, but... I hear some pros and cons about what's happening, but since Hansen's taken over the head boss and whatnot, the district for education, how do you think he's performed as far as educating the kids and whatnot? You know, sure, there's going to be board members that are not going to like him, and some of them are going to like him. But my concern is, number one is education for kids. Now, he's been a plus, that what I see in Red and Juana as far as, excelling, being the superintendent and whatnot, I think sometimes we get into ruts, and even board members, even in Sanger's the same way. We don't agree to everything, but my concern as a parent is always first the kids versus what's happening over there, because the federal government will take care of it. Yeah, you take in consideration what's happened in a lot of situations, but yourself, you brought it out, and it's in the air, and let the federal government take care of the FBI, take care of the situation. If there's something, it's going to be found. If there's nothing, let it go. But my main concern, Brooke, is this. We've got to excel in educating the kids, and that's the first and foremost thing that I'm amped about as far as, I'm not a real educated person, but when it comes to kids, I want them educated. They've got the best teachers, and that's the way it's going to be. Okay. So that's my question to you is let the federal government take care of it, the FBI, whatever, and let it be. That's it.
Okay.
I agree with you. It's in their hands. They're taking care of it, and they're going to do what they're going to do, and that's why I'm trying to not give an opinion on winners and losers, who's guilty, who's not guilty. That's not my job. That's the government's job. I agree with you 100% as far as educating kids. How has he done? Well, I can tell you that on some regards he's done well, and on other regards he's not done so well. We've had the education gap, the academic gap, it hasn't moved, and 48% of our kids can pass an A through
G. One moment, caller.
52% are not passing an A through G. 2% are college ready. 2%.
That's amazing.
98% are not. So
wow.
How has he done? I think you look at the scorecard and I've said it before. If he was in the NFL, if he was a coach in the NFL or in my preparation, my personal belief in watching football is to watch college. My preference is college football, but if he was a coach in college football, would we keep him around if you look at the scorecard? In the NFL, NFL really stands for not for long if you're not performing. So we need to look at performance, and the performance indexes are out there. Everybody can go for themselves. In my opinion, we haven't moved the ball.
2% of the students at Fresno Unified are college ready.
That's
2%.
Those are his numbers.
That my son is not one of those. Well, he better be ready. And he's in high school now. He better be ready.
And if he's not, what's the plan? So if he's not college ready, so what do you do? He's got to get a job. So that's what I'm saying. If we don't go into a career technical education, if we don't get these kids ready for a career.
Hang on, caller.
Instead of college, what are we doing? We're turning out homeless. We're turning out thugs. We're
unemployed.
Turning out people that are marching for a $15 an hour minimum wage. I mean, those are the people that we're turning out. We have got to stop the bleeding. We've got to stop it.
Caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Yes. I have a question regarding the leaseback deal there. It sounds like it was a more or less a design build thing where the schools didn't have to hire their own architect, civil engineers, and such, and prepare all the plans and then bid them out. Rather, they gave the constructor the specifications, and he came up with his own architects, his own plans, and you just had to approve them.
You're 100% correct on what it is. It was kind of a design build. The problem with it is that the district, and this is the entire argument for the Davis versus Fresno Unified lawsuit, is that the district, not the board, the district entered into pre-construction agreements with the developer / contractor / design build guy before, months and sometimes a year before, the board knew that they had done that. And so the district in this state, in this country, doesn't have the ability to enter into those contracts. The board enters into contracts. and it's the law. And it, and the law says that if the district enters into a contract with a developer, with a contractor, with a consultant, with a design build guy, and it's not ratified by the board, it's like hiring a non-licensed contractor. The district doesn't have to pay. And so that's the problem with Davis versus Unified, is Davis is saying, give the district the money back, because what you did was illegal, and the contractor, developer, design build guy has to pay it back.
Well, if this happened and it's illegal, why isn't somebody in jail already?
Well, it's illegal. It's not a criminal proceeding that it's illegal. It's illegal as far as the Ed Code to do it. And
gotcha.
The repercussions mean you pay the money back.
Gotcha.
It's just like a non-licensed contractor that if he does the roof of your house and he's non-licensed, you don't have to pay him.
But
and
it's not a criminal act.
It's not a criminal act. That's correct.
Caller, are you satisfied? Anything else?
Yes. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. I want to quote you out of the paper here today in this article talking about Michael Hansen saying that he is serving as the district's lead on the collection of documents for the subpoena, working with Discovia, the San Francisco-based firm, to collect all these documents. And you say our CEO, which got us into this questionable mess or circumstance, is also the lead on the collection of these documents. How do you explain that?
Well, and I had a conversation with the superintendent yesterday, and I told him, I said, Mike, I said, why would you do this? Why would you put yourself in that situation? This doesn't make any sense.
Mm-hmm.
You're at the forefront of this quagmire, if you will, and now you're gonna publicly come out and say that you're the lead on collecting these documents? He didn't have an answer for me per se, you know, other than, well, I'm kind of doing it, but I'm kind of not. I said, this makes no sense to me, and I disagree with it, and I don't think that you should have anything to do with it. We've got 12,000 employees at Fresno Unified. Can't we have somebody else be the lead?
So somebody has to be in charge of collecting those documents. It should not be him. Who should it be?
Well, we've hired Carl Fowler, a very well-known lawyer that used to be a prosecutor, and he's the one that's doing it, but somebody has to do it. In my
mind,
let's just try to give the very appearance of complete transparency.
Carl Fowler, by the way, Carl Fowler, by the way, is the one who leaked the information in a private meeting about the CyberDust app. Am I correct about that?
I don't think so. Carl Fowler.
He was in that private meeting, though.
He might have been in the private meeting, but Carl.
He's
Fowler
not the one who leaked
no,
it.
No, absolutely not. Nobody leaked it. It came out in a Mark Arax article. It wasn't leaked. Janet Ryan thought that I was leaking things to the press.
I was going to ask you. You didn't leak it, right?
Absolutely not. 100%.
Okay.
If anything, if you go back and read the article, Janet Ryan leaked it. She's the one that told the Bee what happened in the meeting. Read the article.
But is Fowler the one who told the board, the trustees, about the cyber app?
He did.
Okay, but he's not the one who leaked it.
That's correct.
And you didn't leak it. You think Janet Ryan did.
No, I'm saying that Janet Ryan, when she talked to the Bee, she's the one that came forward with all the information that thought that I had said it. She was giving it up. Read the article.
Yeah. No, I've got it here.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got all the articles. It's amazing to read through. It's like a book. It's incredible. Caller, you're on the air with Brooke Ashton. Go ahead.
Yeah. In reference to the Mr. Hansen having his hand in the collection of data, you're exactly right. I mean, I'm Andy Favella, and it's like we hire these people for $100,000, Fowler and so forth, and that's why we hired him, was to collect all this information, and to follow the subpoena, and that's why we did that stuff. I don't know why Mr. Hansen wants to be a part of it, or why he should be a part of it, because, we've hired Decovia and Mr. Fowler to do all this work for us, so he should not be a part of it, because he is, a part of that investigation. So I think the board should tell him to just keep his hands away from it and stay out of it. I don't know why the board is unable to do that.
Well, you raise
it. Next meeting tomorrow, they should tell him that, to just keep his hands out of it.
You raise a very interesting point. And so tomorrow we are voting on new board leadership. Meaning that Cal Johnson, who's our president of the board this year, in my mind, we could have done things a little bit differently. So I'm going to leave it at that.
He doesn't have a problem, by the way, with this CyberDust thing. At least that's what he said. That's what he told the Bee.
In my mind, we could have done things a lot differently this year, this last year.
Yeah.
And so we're going to end up with a new board president. I'm hoping that it's going to be the person. I'm hoping that it's going to be Luis Chavez that is a great guy. I'm going to call him a Reagan Democrat. He's run for a couple of offices, but he's got a lot of common sense, and he has the ability to unite people, and he is a no-nonsense, hard-charging guy. And so I think that we're going to see a board president that actually leads a board.
Okay. Brooke Ashton is here. He is a board member, a trustee with Fresno Unified School District. They have a board meeting tomorrow. We'll see what happens there. And again, the front page of the Fresno Bee today, I'll just hold it up one more time here. It's about Fresno Unified trustees having to hand over all of their electronic devices dating back to 2009. That means everything. I mean, cell phones, the whole nine yards, in regards to this no-bid contracts that all these construction projects that have taken place over the past few years. 436 Mean TV, option 11, and our sponsor today, Dr. Thomas Casagrande for 2020 Optometrics.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on Energy Star qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
Take a look at this.
Let's play.
This is too hip for you. I'll slow down.
Let's play.
Watch all your favorite classic game shows on Buzzer TV, KBBC Digital Channel 13.7.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. I gotta go see that guy. I need some new specs. You ever been over to Casa Grande, by the way?
No.
I gotta go see him. He's a good guy, I hear.
Is he?
Yeah, that's what I hear.
And the older I get, the more I need him.
Yeah, well, I gotta my dollar store specs here. I gotta go upgrade.
Yep.
So has Fresno Unified asked for when I say Fresno Unified, any of the top officials in the district office asked for the district to pay for any kind of criminal defense attorneys?
Well, yeah, we originally got the request for Mike and Ruthie and Karen Temple asked that the board ratify and approve criminal attorneys to represent them and have the taxpayers of Fresno pay for it.
And what was the reaction from the board?
Well, the first time it came to the board, it went 3-3, and, it was a no vote. And so because we were missing, Chris De La Serta was ill that day, and then the second time it came to the board, it went 4-3.
Against?
Four, two, and Janet Ryan abstained. So, against it was myself, Carol Mills, Chris De La Serta, Luis Chavez. For it was Cal Johnson, Valerie Davis, and Janet Ryan abstained, wasn't going to vote.
Yeah, so the board voted against it ultimately, so they will not get that paid for if they need a criminal defense attorney as far as Fresno Unified is concerned. And so just a couple of email questions here. Let's see, this one says, how long are phone records, text logs recorded by law to be kept intact? In other words, what does a law say? Okay, if this is a public document, taxpayer money, I need the phone records to stay intact for this amount of time.
You know, I don't know, because you're asking about emails and phone records and text messages. Each one of those is differently. I understand that we have all of the emails back from 2009, but the federal subpoena is more than that. I mean, they've asked for, we want to see your credit card receipts. We want to see how you went on vacation. We want to know how you paid on for that vacation.
We want to see your bank account.
I am anticipating they're asking for bank accounts. We want to see your frequent flyer miles, your trips. They're asking, I mean, we are under a very, very large microscope. And the federal government's going to do their due diligence, like the previous one of the previous callers had said, and we're going to let it fall where it falls.
Yeah. Have we ever seen anything like this? Hang on, caller. In just a moment, I'll get to you. Thank you. Have we ever seen anything the likes of this, either in the Central Valley or in California?
I know that I haven't. I can't speak for the Central Valley or the rest of California. I mean, maybe Operation Rezone.
Yeah.
You know,
but with a school district, with any particular school district.
Not that I know of. Not that I know of.
And it's embarrassing.
It's
disheartening.
It's
considering all the other things that are going on in the district with the kids and lack of education.
Amen.
You know,
I don't know.
All right, caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yes. Can you tell me what is going to happen with design science? I mean, they were building the entrepreneurial school for design science, and then Hansen got the idea for the other thing that was there. And so they kind of forgot about design science. And when parents were there at the last board meeting asking about what happened to their program, nobody had an answer. And even top district administrators were saying, you know, boy, we really should get a program, or really should do something about design science, because we have no idea what to do with it. And I think that's pretty irresponsible of a district administration to not know what you're going to do with a program that's so successful, and yet, do all these other things that are affecting students. I think that's a great program, design science. I mean, where can you get a high school diploma and also an AA degree at the same time? And the school district that doesn't do anything about it, or they're just going to kick it aside.
That's a great question. So what the caller is asking about, design science high school, you can go to high school and at the same time go to Fresno City College. So when you graduate, not only do you have a high school diploma, you also have an AA degree from a city college that you could almost transfer into a UC, or you could transfer into UC, you could transfer into a Fresno State with 60 units completed. And so what happened was, when we went and built this Patino Entrepreneurial School, which was originally slated to be an expansion of design science, we kind of kicked the design science kids to the curb, and we put the new kids, the entrepreneurial kids, into this new building, this $12 or $14 million building. And it was a surprise to the board. And so at the last board meeting, I asked for board communication from the superintendent. What are we doing with the design science kids? What's going to happen there? And I haven't received it yet. So I will be asking again tomorrow night, what are we going to do, and I'm not going to wait through Christmas, with the design science kids, and where are they going to go, and how are we going to fulfill the requirements that we've made to them, the promises that we made to them. There was quite a few kids that came, and it is a great program. It's one of the successful programs that we're doing. And
sounds great, but you don't know if you're going to get an answer tomorrow night. You have no idea at this point.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. And so that's why it's so, John, that's why it's so important to have a great board president, because when you don't get an answer, you go to your board president and say, hey, superintendent didn't answer me.
Yeah,
what are you
going to
do?
To find out. What are you going to do about
it? Yeah, what are you going to do? I want to know. And so instead of him just not speaking to one board member or two board members, you know, superintendents learned in kindergarten that they can count to four. When you got seven members on a board, all you got to do is keep four happy. And if you keep four happy, you keep your job. Well, pretty soon the erosion has been taking place, and
so how much support is he losing?
Well, I can tell you
from
this:
from the four that were there,
I can tell you this: that at some point the four becomes three, and Fresno is going to succeed again.
Wow, that's a big statement coming from Brooke Ashton here. Caller, anything else you'd like to ask?
When they denied Ruthie Quinto's, propane for Ruthie Quinto's lawyer, did that vote also mean that they weren't going to vote for Hansen and for Karen Temple's attorneys, or is that still up for a vote.
They could bring that back. You're 100% correct. They could bring that back, and they could come in and they could ask for that again. And in fact, one of the four that voted no, so myself, Luis, Carol, Chris, if we decided to, we could say, you know what, I want to bring that vote back.
You could.
And we could bring that vote back. Now,
what's
is that going to happen?
Likely possibility of that happening?
With me?
None.
On my deathbed, it wouldn't happen.
Caller, thanks for your input. Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, I want to ask you about this guy, Pete Shearer. He was quoted in the Fresno Bee. He is the executive director of the First Amendment Coalition in the Bay Area. I spoke to him a couple of months ago, and he said, you know what? This is not only this cyber app erasing these documents and using this stuff on your cell phone to erase text messages and all that. It's a violation of the Public Records Act. It is skating on thin ice, and it's very similar to taking a hard copy document and putting it in the shredder. Agree?
Powerful words. How could you disagree with that?
It's like putting things in the shredder.
It's, yeah. Well, I think it's worse than that. It's putting them in the shredder and then burning it.
But with everything, you see, here's the thing about the electronics. I mean, you're not Bill Gates and you're not Steve Jobs. Of course, Steve Jobs passed away, but, and you may not be able to answer this, and I certainly can't because I don't know. I should call my son and ask him. If you erase something with cyber dust, can it ever be retrieved, or is it out there in the universe someplace and we just can't get it? That's the thing that I don't know.
They say that there is no digital footprint. I mean, they say it is gone. It's
forever.
It's over. It's over. Now, is that the case? I mean, I don't know. I mean, you would think that if it was, why aren't the jihadists and the ISIS groups, why aren't they using it? I mean, it sounds like it's something of a terrorist organization or a drug dealer would want to use, or a husband that's cheating on his wife. I mean, yeah. those are the things that come to my mind of why you'd want to use it, right?
As opposed to a superintendent of a school district, why would he want to use it?
Well, he said it was for ease of use.
Wow. Amazing. Hey, Brooke Ashton is our guest here, 436-ME-TV, option 11. If any of you out there have the answer to my question, can any of this stuff be retrieved through cyber dust? I mean, is it gone forever, 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 forever? It can never be retrieved. I thought even if something is erased, it's still out there in outer space someplace that we can retrieve it through satellite images or something. I don't know. If you have the answer to that question, call in. 436-ME-TV, option 11. I'm dating myself now, as you can see, because I have limited knowledge in the electronic world of today, today's world that we live in. Back in just a moment. And when I say limited knowledge, I mean like zero.
KitchenAid innovation and quality. Who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on Energy Star qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. Back here on the program with Brooke Ashton. He is a school board trustee with Fresno Unified School District. And I've got to ask you, in light of this mess that's going on, this scandal, I guess I should call it, with Fresno Unified, you glad you ran? You glad you're a board trustee?
You know, there's days that I'm happy and there's days that I'm sad. And so I want to do a really good job. I want to make Fresno, I love Fresno. My family's been here 100 years. My dad had a business down the street from with this location, and I believe in Fresno. I believe in our children. I believe in our kids, and I'm glad that I ran. But I feel like at some points I'm spinning my wheels just a little bit because I can't get the traction that I'm used to in the private sector. I can tell you this, John, that we are going to make a difference. We are going to get a career technical.
How can one man make a difference, though, on that board? You're only one vote, one person. I've always wondered that, because even in the U.S. House of Representatives, you're only one of 435. You're only one of, say, 100 senators. You're only one president. You can't. Can one person make a difference on that board?
You know, I would say to you that if you've ever slept in a dark room with one mosquito, right? No matter how many people in the room, you only got one mosquito. It bothers everybody. And I'm kind of that mosquito that just bothers people. And so
who are
maybe,
you bothering?
Yeah, all of them. And I'm saying to them, we've got to do better. We've got to do better. We've got to move the ball, and we've got to move it in a big way. And I really believe that if we can move the ball with career technical education, we can do great things for Fresno. I believe we could end homelessness, and we could end the major poverty of the county of Fresno in less than 10 years if we put this thing into play.
Why aren't we doing it then? Hang on, caller.
I don't know. We've got the money set aside. We got $10 million set aside in a budget. We haven't spent $1 yet. I don't know. I can't get the superintendent to get traction. We've been distracted by all of this other stuff, and we've got to go and look at how we're going to help children and help teenagers and help people get jobs. When I go places, they say to me, you know, some of the upper kids say, the upper echelon kids say, I say, where are you going next year? I'm going to UCLA. I'm going to Harvard. I'm going to Dartmouth. I'm going to
Sounds
UC
like
Davis.
My
right?
kids.
Right?
Sounds like my kids, yeah.
Well, they've got a plan. I go to the other kids and I say, where are you going? You know, Mr. Ashton, if I could just get a job. My dad doesn't have a job. My mom doesn't have a job. I just want to get a job. And I'm not talking about getting a job of a minimum wage job. I'm talking about teaching kids on how to get jobs that make $60,000, $80,000, $100,000 a year, where they're buying cars, they're buying houses, they're actively contributing to society. And once we get that thing in play, you're going to see a different face of Fresno County.
Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, but let me ask another question here. I think that I promised too, if the federal was involved in that, they should go to the contractor, because somehow, some way, if Hanson and the contractors got that deal, so it had to be there had to be some kind of communication. Now they could have, like you say, they with a cyber, they could have, you know, erased everything, the talk, whatever, texting, but That person they should be going to is a contractor, get all his equipment to see if there was communication between the superintendent. And that word, that problem might be coming up, because by now, with all what's put in the paper and all, they're smart. They're going to erase everything they got the same way, you know. But, you know, you were talking about the kids, 2%. I think the thing is that I think we as parents, we have to be the teachers, because the teachers cannot do everything at school, okay? And it's our fault as parents, and I come from a gang area, but it doesn't make any difference. If we put in their heads that we are going to push them and get them through like you're doing, it's getting all these questions, which I love, because someone has to answer for what they did, okay? And I firmly believe that you're one of them that will help the district, do a better job.
Okay.
So,
thank you.
I appreciate your confidence. I can tell you this, that and I know we're short on time, but I'll tell you this, is that you've raised a couple of different points. One, they are looking at the contractors. The federal government is looking at them as well. Two, the disintegration of the family is the single most demon which has demonized our generation. The ability of not having the mothers and the fathers coming together and the absenteeism has been terrible.
It's been a long time problem.
It's just terrible.
A question here, an email question, is Harris Construction potentially in danger of prosecution? That's one. And the second question is, are you calling for Michael Hanson to resign?
That would be a board decision. I am not. I would not do that publicly. I've expressed some of my discontent with the superintendent of our school, And
I think at some point he might resign?
You know, I don't know. I think that I would rather than puff my chest on MeTV, I'd rather have that conversation eyeball to eyeball with Mike Hansen. And I would welcome that kind of conversation. I don't, to answer the Harris question, I don't know what their involvement is or the extent of how they're dealing with the federal government. I don't wish them any ill. I just want to know what happened and how we get through it and try to fix it so that Fresno Unified doesn't face these problems anymore and we get open bidding to all people that are qualified to bid our jobs.
And as far as Hansen is concerned, the legal way to get him out of office is the board has to vote him out?
The board hires him, the board fires him.
And it has to be a 4-3 vote?
It has to be 4+.
4+.
That's correct. Well, four or more.
Yeah. Okay, but at least four. It's got to be 4-3.
It has to be a majority.
Yeah, there's got to be a majority to take him out. Time for one more quick phone call, and then we're going to go here. We only got about 2 minutes left. Caller, you're on the air very quickly because we're short on time. Only a couple of minutes left, please.
Yes, I don't think the board would want to fire him because of the fact of that huge payout that's in his contract. But then again, you know, if you wanted to technically with this contract, I think you could just beginning if it's three consecutive unsatisfactories, you get to you can obviously be fired.
The contract is actually public, so you can see it. And the buyout is not what a normal buyout would be. Normal buyouts are like 18 months. Mm-hmm. I think Mr. Hansen's buyout is 12 months. Mm-hmm. But again, I'm not here to discuss the buyout of him or the firing of him or whatever's going to happen there. If he could move the ball, then let's move the ball. But if he can't move the ball, let's get somebody that can move the ball.
Yeah, and if you vote him out to fire him, he could come back with legal action too.
Well, it is what it is.
Right? Yeah, you never know.
Correct.
Brooke, you know, I always enjoy having you here.
Thank you.
And you're an honest guy.
Thank you.
And thanks for pouring your thoughts out to us in a very honest, open way. I really appreciate it. And continued success.
Thank you.
On the board. Hope you get this thing straightened out soon.
Always happy to come here. Thank you, John.
I don't know if the feds know when this thing's going to come to a head, but we'll find out soon, I guess.
We need guys that are calling hard shots like you're able to call them, and I appreciate all you're doing for the community. Thank you.
Well, thank you. We appreciate you, too. Thanks, Brooke. All right. Brooke Ashton, one of the good guys here, a board member trustee for Fresno Unified. Tomorrow we'll talk about the Right to Die bill that was signed by Governor Brown just in early October. And then we're going to have somebody in here that really does not agree with that too much. So interesting program tomorrow. See you then. Have a good day.